What's up, YouTube? Capital G here. We got more Danger Darkworld action for you guys to check out. The absurdness of this archetype is just absolutely baffling. And I'm not really trying to hype this archetype up just for the views and the clicks and all that good stuff. I'm hyping it up because I believe that this archetype is fucking nuts. And I do believe that it will be competitive. There's a couple of things here that, I'm thinking about. And maybe these are just conspiracy theories. But I believe that Konami R&D and the TCG like Jerome McHale, I believe that there was a legitimate effort to make this deck stronger than our previous TCG exclusives. You guys know I lamented those fucking decks. I lambasted them when they were first revealed. I mean, when they showed us Revendreds, I basically was like, I'm fucking out. Like, they showed us the first four cards of the deck, and I was like, throw this shit in the garbage. I don't like it. I'm not saying every ritual deck has to be Necroz level, but I just got the sense that it was just going to be terrible, and it ended up being terrible. FAs were underwhelming. They got some good cards like Don Dragster and some other good cards, but you know, they were never really full-on competitive. But at least with FA, it's like, all right, we at least see that they're doing some interesting things. With Revendreds, I was like, forget it. But the Danger deck just seems so good, and really it's just the fact that it's kind of built like a GX deck. There's so much draw power. I don't think anyone saw this kind of being a link spam deck. I don't even think Konami intended on it being a link spam deck. But then there's the Nightmares. Those have just fundamentally changed how most Yu-Gi-Oh decks just link summon right now, because they're so generic and so easily, or you can put them on the board so easily that, yeah, this deck is just honestly ridiculous, especially when you combine Firewall, the fact that Graffa can be summoned an infinite amount of times from the graveyard, and then you can just, you know, summon Beige an infinite amount of times. Like, that's how you get your link spam with this deck. There are also just enablers like Skull Dread and Soul Charge. So this one is going to be different. It has the normal summon of your tour guide from the underworld, and as long as you can just kind of keep cards in your hand, you're basically just always going to have some type of resources. You see the Skull Drake. Look, even when you get down to just a couple of cards in hand, you're like, oh, Cappy's gonna run out of momentum here. He doesn't really have anything to sustain. Nope, you've got Snow. Once you get Snow, you can basically just use Snow over and over and over again. Snow just keeps searching copies of Snow. That's basically your infinite fodder. Discard Snow, draw cards with Nessie at the same time. This one plays Dragon Down. I don't think drag down is necessary in this deck. Double drag down keeps giving you fodder. You hit a power card like Soul Charge, get all these three monsters back from the graveyard, and then you can just start putting them back in your hand with Graffa to be able to use over and over and over again. So you end up using Snow like five times in a turn, and then you can like special summon the Snow off of Firewall Dragon. You can put it back in your hand with Graffa. You can continue to activate discard effects. So yeah, Snow is really would just bust this deck. Snow, I guess, breaks Darkworld, but there are so many different factors that breaks this deck. And then when you add the Nightmares, which, you know, I feel like every video I see a Nightmare, I just say every video that Nightmares were a mistake as an archetype. I believe that they are super unhealthy for Yu-Gi-Oh, but I mean, I'm not gonna complain because fuck it, they're here now. So it is what it is. And you can see he's basically just building the extra link here relatively easily, just off the back of things like Beige and Graffa not being hard once per turn. You end up getting your Ibli, you force it on your opponent's side of the field as he makes his unicorn, and then you can also, you know, use your two Graffas or your multiple Graffas. You can go for Titanic Galaxy, and this is the board that you end with. And yeah, this guy has a little less resources in hand, but I think the card economy is still fundamentally solid, because I mean, you open with five cards. I mean, dude's got five link monsters on the field. Then he has two more really strong cards in Titanic Galaxy and then Gates, and he has a couple of cards in hand. And even if the Titanic Galaxy dies, you just fall back on, like, you know, beating the crap out of your opponent with Graffa, as it's very easy to get that off. And I believe Firewall Dragon is live. It's linked with two monsters, so it's like, this is an incredible field. Like, tell me right now, yes, there is no, I guess, Trigate Wizard, but honestly, just look at this. Wouldn't you say that this is as good as a GOUKI board? And did GOUKI not just win the fucking NAWCQ? I think that this board is legitimately as good. Yeah, it doesn't stop monster effects, but you do have a Firewall bounce of two. You have a bunch of co-link monsters. You have a spell negation that Trigate Wizard is generally used on, because you have your Titanic Galaxy. You still have your Ibli locking your opponent out. And then you have Graffa as another boss monster to just summon. Now, the thing about this deck is, And most people might not get this reference. It is somewhat similar to Lightsworn when they first came out. Like, there was a point in time, people probably think this is crazy, there used to be a point in time where Lightsworn players would actually deck themselves out. That used to be a real thing. Lightsworn, you had about four turns, maybe five if you got lucky. And after that, you kind of like burn yourself out and you would actually lose the duel by deck out. And this deck is kind of similar to that. You see, after just one turn, only five cards in deck. So you gotta be careful with this deck, because you can deck out. We saw that in the other duel. If you guys notice, his opponent, or I believe the guy who was popping off with the Danger Darkworld, he had no cards in deck after like two turns. So yeah, it's very possible for you to deck yourself out. Now, his opponent is playing a Shadow Darkworld version of Danger. I think it's significantly worse. I don't really get, I mean, yeah, Shadow Beast, but like, I just, why? Just don't even, man. Just stick with Darkworld and Danger. Running things like the Fables are okay, because he has like Fable, you know, Cerebellum, and that's kind of cool, but his opponent is just going to Firewall Bounce, and there's pretty much no coming back from that. He's able to, even though, as I said, he lost Titanic Galaxy, doesn't matter, because you can just get your graphics back. He's going to go into Unicorn. I think this is just completely unnecessary. He could just go for beatdown and probably win the game, but it is what it is. He's still able to get Graffa. He's going for more of the style points here, and Firewall Dragon just being used over and over and over again. That right there is enough damage for an OTK. I don't really feel like it's necessary to show this build, because it's essentially the build you guys saw yesterday, just with Dragdowns put into it. I don't know if I like Dragdown. Just is nuts going first, but going second, not so much. And honestly, other than hitting Droll, what do you even need to stop? Like, Ash Blossom is not going to stop this deck. Like, it just isn't. One Ash Blossom, there's too much draw support in this deck to be stopped by like one copy of Ash Blossom. So I'm not really sure that Dragdown is really good. Like, GOUKI ran it because they wanted to stop hand traps. They wanted to stop things like Winter Cherries and whatnot. Maybe Winter Cherries can hit the Firewall Dragon and then you can't extra link. But in general, I don't even know if Dragdown is really necessary, especially bad going second and whatnot. But yeah, this deck is very real. And when we get Cybernetic Horizon, I believe that there will be a rush to get these cards. We already know the rarities are very high, like, you know, Danger Bigfoot is a secret rare, Nessie is a secret rare. These might be expensive cards. At first I said that and I was like, I don't know if I really believe that shit, but these can be expensive cards because the deck is fucking legitimate. So thank you guys for watching. As always, subscribe if you have not already and turn on that notification bell for daily videos.